Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna sent to me. Ding bang.
嗯，稍等啊，我把音乐关掉。好的，好的，我们现在可以了，准备好了。
好。Om Jnana Timarandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chatsur Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschachya Desatarine Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. So we're recounting the fifth canto Srimad Bhagavatam, chapter number... Is it 19?
Yes.
And we're hearing about description of Jambudvip, and we're particularly hearing about the glories of Bharatvarsha. So it's described how even the demigods in heaven, they glorified Bharatvarsha.
这里描述到，即便是在天堂新修的这些半世人，他们都在荣耀 Bharatvarsha 这片地方。
And they say those people who have got human bodies who are born in Bharatvarsha, they're more fortunate than the demigods.
他们说那些投身在巴尔塔瓦沙之地的这些人甚至比半世人们更幸运。
They must have performed so much austerity and pious activities in their previous life.
他们一定从事过很多的虔诚和苦行的这些活动在他们的前一生。
Or maybe somehow they pleased the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
或者他们一定取悦过至尊人格守神本人。
Otherwise, how else could we explain why they're so fortunate to be able to have the opportunity to do devotional service?
否则的话，他们怎么可能以如此的方式在那里从事奉献服务呢？
So we demigods, the demigods are praying. They said we're hoping that we can somehow get a human birth in Bharatvarsh and do devotional service there.
我们这些半神们也非常渴望能够以人体的形式的生命投身在巴尔塔瓦舍之地，在那里从事奉爱服务。
So to take a birth in Bharatvarsh is described in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. There's one verse.
在永恒的柴塔尼亚经里面有这么一个诗节，描述了巴尔塔巴沙之地。
Bharata bhumite haila manushya janmajar janmasartaka karikara parupakar. One who is to get the human body in India, Bharatvarsh, it's very rare.
一个投身在印度巴尔塔巴沙之地的人们是非常罕见的。
So the person who has that opportunity, they should make their life successful by becoming Krishna conscious, and then they should work for the benefit of others.
在那里投身的人应该让他的生命变得成功，同时为人类的福祉而工作。
Because when you're born in Bharatvarsh, then it's very easy.To understand about devotional service.
因为如果你投身在巴尔塔巴沙之地的话，是非常容易理解奉爱服务的。
Because the people are brought up in the culture, so it's just so natural for them to understand and to accept.
因为人们生活就出生在这种文化之中，所以他们非常天然的能够接受这样的。
Everyone who is born in this place, they understand about the law of karma, and they understand the nature of the material world.
在这里出生的人，他们天然的、天生的就能理解 karma 活动业报的这个法律，他们也能够理解这个物质自然的本性。
And they know about higher planets and demigods and hellish planets and punishments for the sinful people.
他们也能够了解高等的星球那里的人们，还有一些地狱星球那些罪恶的人们。
So it makes it so easy for such people when they're born into that culture. It's so easy, so natural for them to take up devotional service.
因此，出生在这样的一种文化的这片土地上，他们非常很容易就能够理解和培养奉爱服务。
But they should recognize their duty.To also distribute this knowledge to other people around the world.
但是他们也得同时觉悟到自己，我们应该把这个承担起这个社会的这个责任，把这个文化传遍到世界的其他的地方去。
They shouldn't think that it's only just for India.
他们不应该认为这个文化只是给印度人。
They should think everyone is a part and parcel of Krishna, and they all need to be awakened to Krishna consciousness.
他们应该理解到每一个人都是 Krishna 的一部分，每一个人都应该被唤醒去了解 Krishna.
So these demigods, those who are offering these prayers, they understood that in their past they had done a lot of pious activities to become demigods.
这些办事人们祈祷到他们了解到他们要成为办事人前世经过很多的虔诚的活动。
We must have done austerities, we must have given a lot of charity, we must have practiced different rules and regulations.
这些办事人说，我们前世也经历过很多的艰难的苦行誓言，做了很多的布施。
But they said, now we're here in heavenly planets, we have a lot of sense gratification.
我们现在已经来到了这个天堂星球，但是呢，我们却在这里从事了很多的感官享乐的活动。
So it's very hard for us to think of the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord.
因此在这里非常难以想起主的莲花足。
And they said, because we had so much sense gratification, we've practically forgotten about the lotus feet of the Lord.
而且事实上，由于我们过度的感官享乐，我们几乎忘记了主的莲花足。
So one of the benefits of being born in Bharatvarsh is thatPeople can go, you can go directly back to Godhead from taking birth, after taking birth in Bharatvarsh. From Bharatvarsh, you can go directly to the spiritual world.
投身在巴尔塔巴沙之地的这个人，他的一个便利条件在于，他可以直接的返回家园，回到守神身边。
People in Bharatvarsh, usually they follow the Vedic principles and they perform different sacrifices.
投身在巴尔塔巴沙之地的这些人，通常他们都遵循伟大的原则，而且举行祭祀。
But often the purpose of their sacrifice is simply to go to the heavenly planets. They're thinking the goal of life is to go to the heavenly planets.
通常情况下， 人们从事祭祀是想要到达天堂星球，因为他们认为他们的目标就是天堂星球。
Because they know long life in the heavenly planets and a lot of sense gratification. So they think that's what I want.
因为他们知道在天堂星球他们可以有好很长时间的生命，而且可以做很多的这个感官享乐，这就是他们想要的生活。
But what they don't think about is that they may go to the heavenly planets, but they can't stay there forever.
但是人们虽然知道这一点，但是他们不知道的事情是，他们虽然可以去到天堂星球，但是他们不可以在那里一直待下去。
They can enjoy there for some time.But they have to again come back. When they finish all their pious activities, they come back.
他们在那里可以待上一段时间，但是当他们的虔诚活动耗尽的时候，他们必须得回来。
But if they worship Krishna, if they can become Krishna conscious, they can go back to Godhead and never have to come to the material world again.
然而具有 Krishna 知觉的人，他可以直接的回归 Krishna 的身边，回到守神那边，而且永远不必再回来。
So the demigods, they regret that they took their birth in the higher planets.
因此那些半神人们投身在天堂星球，
他
们非常后悔投身到天堂星球。
Before they became demigods, previouslyThey may have been born, they may have been in Bharatvarsha, but instead of going back to Godhead, they just wanted to go to heaven.
因为这些去到天堂星球的这些人，有可能之前也是在Bharatvarsha之地投身的，但是呢，他们没有在Bharatvarsha之地直接回归守神，而是想要去到天堂星球，所以到了天堂星球。
Because they could understand.There's better sense gratification in the heavenly planets, so they thought, I should go there, I should enjoy there.
因为他们之前认为在天堂星球有更高的感官享乐，他们觉得我们应该去那里，去到天堂星球，去那里享受。
But when they go there, so at the time, the point was at the time of death, they didn't rememberKrishna, they didn't think of Vishnu or Krishna, they simply thought about their sense gratification.
但是虽然有感官享乐，问题在于在他们临死之际的时候，他们无法想起 Krishna, 无法想起至尊人格守身，以致不能回归。
So they,
他们只想的是感官享乐。
They lost the opportunity. They had such a good birth in Bharatvarsha, but they wasted it.
因此他们失去了这个机会。他们浪费了这个机会，虽然他们投身在巴尔塔巴舍之地。
So they instead of going back to Godhead, they simply went to the higher planets. So they went to heaven.
因为没有回归到，因为没有直接回归到回归人回到守神的身边，他们却去了天堂星球。
So what we should really want is to go back to Godhead, either to go to Vaikuntha.Or go to Goloka Vrindavan.
因此，我们应该真正渴望想要去到回到守神的身边，要么就去瓦昆塔，要么就去 Goloka Vrindavan.
There's just a little difference. If you go to Vaikuntha there, then the mood is in Dasharas. The different rasas are there. Now, Dasharas is predominant in Vaikuntha. Everyone's a servant of the Lord.
Goloka Vrindavan 和这个瓦昆塔有一点点的区别，在瓦昆塔那里的人们主要是以 Dasara Rasa 的这个心态，以仆人对待主的这个心态。
But if you want to go
两个地方的 Rasa 不一样。
But if you want to go into Goloka, you have to worship Krishna in the mood of the people of Vrindavan.
如果你要去 Goloka Vrindavan 的话，在那里崇拜 Krishna 的心态是以 Vrindavan 的心态崇拜主 Krishna。
And the people of Vrindavan, they don't think of Krishna as God. They think of Krishna as their son, or as their friend, or as their lover.
在 Vrindavan 的居民， 于 Krishna 的心态是，他们不认为 Krishna 是主，他们认为 Krishna 是他们的爱人、朋友或者是孩子。
So they think of Krishna through one of the rasas.
所以他们跟 Krishna 是有这种不同的 rasa 关系。
But higher rasa than Vaikuntha.
而且是高于 Vaikuntha 的这种 rasa.
They're not in Vaikuntha. They think of Krishna as God, and they're His servant. You know, Krishna is the supreme Lord, Vishnu, and they worship Him with great respect and reverence.
在 Vaikuntha, 他们认为至尊主，他们认为 Krishna 是至尊主本人。所以他们给予至尊主很多的敬畏之心。
But in Goloka, it's more just intimacy, very sweet relationships with Krishna.
但是在 Goloka, 人们和 Krishna 是非常甜美的这种关系。
So, a short life, huh?The demigods are continuing to pray. They said, even if you have a short life in Bharatvarsha, it's better than living as a demigod for millions of years in heaven.
这些半神人们继续写道道，即便在 Bharatvarsha 里的这些人们只有短暂的，也比那些在天堂星球有上百万或数十亿里年的人更好。
And even if you go up to Brahmaloka, the topmost planet in the universe, you can stay there, but still there's birth and death even there.
即便你能去到 Brahmaloka, 而且在那里能够生活百万年，但是你在那里依然有生老病死。
But life in Bharatvarsha, because it's lower,it's not way up in the top of the universe, it's in the middle of the universe, so it's a shorter life. But from that life, one can get full Krishna consciousness.
我刚刚讲错了，在 Brahmaloka 那里不是生老病死，就是在即便你去到 Brahmaloka, 你有可能再次投生。
Yeah.
Gurudev, can you repeat?
Yeah, if you take a birth in Bharatvarsh, although it's in the middle of the universe, so the life there is not long like in Brahma. On Brahma's planet, very long life, but in Bharatvarsh, it's short life compared to the life on Brahmaloka.
在 Bharatvarsha 之地，这个是处在这个中间星球的地带，而Brahmaloka 是比较高等的星球，所以中间星球的这个地带的人的寿命是相对于 Brahmaloka 生的寿命是要短暂一些的。
But although it's a short life, you can become Krishna conscious in that short life.
即便你有生命比较短暂，但是在这短暂的一生，你仍可以发展出 Krishna 知觉。
And in that short life, you can surrender to the lotus feet of the Lord, and you can go back to Godhead.
在这短暂的一生，你可以臣服于 Krishna 本人，然后回到守神。
And if you go back to Godhead, then there's no more birth and death.
如果你能够回到守神，那你没有出生和死亡。
So this is the value of the birth in Bharatvarsha.
这就是出生在 Bharatvarsha 地的价值所在。
So we should just simply surrender to Krishna, take advantage of this opportunity to surrender to Krishna.
因此，我们应该好好的抓住这一次机会，紧紧的臣服于 Krishna.
How to surrender to Krishna? Just remember the ninth chapter, the last verse of the ninth chapter.
如何？臣服于 Krishna 呢？仅仅冥想这个第九篇的最后一个世界、
right.
第九章最后一个世界。
Krishna says the most confidential knowledge.
Krishna 讲了最机密的知识。
And he gives four activities that we have to do.
他给予了四个活动，我们应该做的四个活动。
Engage your mind in thinking of me.
总是让你的心意想着我。
Worship Krishna.
崇拜 Krishna.
Become Krishna's devotee.
成为 Krishna 的奉献者。
And offer obeisances to Krishna.
然后崇拜，然后顶拜 Krishna.
So if we do like that, then Krishna will be very pleased with us, and he can take us back to Godhead.
如果我们做这些的话 ，Krishna 就会对我们满意，他就会把我们带回首身。
Of course, we have to be fit. We have to be qualified to go back to Godhead.
当然，我们应该要有信心，而且要具有资格回归首身。
It means we should be finished with.Trying to enjoy karma, trying to enjoy the results of our work.
We
just want to serve Krishna. We don't want anything in return.
We just want to serve Krishna. We don't want anything in return.
One who is really a devotee, he has no interest in any kind of place where they're not talking about Krishna.
作为一个奉献者，他没有任何兴趣。如果那个他对一个地方没有任何的兴趣，那个地方如果没有 Krishna 的话，他没有任何的兴趣。
Even if it's one of the top planets in the universe, he doesn't want to go there if there's no Krishna consciousness.
即便在这个宇宙的最高的这个星球，如果那里没有 Krishna 知觉的话，他也没有兴趣要去那里。
And if there are no devotees doing devotional service, then he won't want to go there.
如果那里没有奉献者在从事奉献服务的话，他也没有想法想要去那里。
And if there's no Sankirtan, then he also won't want to go.
如果没有 Sankirtan 齐颂圣名的话，他也不想去。
Sankirtan, very important for the devotees. We need association, and with devotees, then you want to have nice kirtan.
Sankirtan, 齐颂圣名对奉献者来说非常的重要。我们要有奉献者的联谊，然后和奉献者在一起联谊的时候，我们要有 kirtan, 唱诵。
So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he appeared to teach everyone the Yuga Dharma, the Sankirtan.
主柴塔尼亚显现就是为了教给我们这个 Yoga Dharma 连带大法 Sankirtan、
right? In the whole universe, this planet is the best. The Earth planet is the best.
在整个宇宙之中，这个地球是最好的星球。
And on the Earth planet, the best place is Bharatvarsha.
而在这个地球星球之中，最好的地方是 Bharatvarsha.
And in Bharatvarsha, the best place is Bengal.
在 Bharatvarsha 中，孟加拉最好。
And in Bengal, the best place is Navadvip.
在孟加拉之中 ，Navadvip 最好。
Navadvip is the best because Lord Chaitanya appeared there to teach everyone Sankirtan.
Navadvip 之所以最好，因为柴塔尼亚马哈帕布在那里显现，并教授人们 Sankirtan。
So, the appearance of Lord Chaitanya is associated with the Sankirtan movement.
主柴塔尼亚显现是由他的机密同游一起，做 Sankirtan 运动。
The devotees always want to chant the names of the Lord, and they're happy to join the Sankirtan movement.
主的奉献者非常想要唱诵主的圣名，而且他想非常高兴加入到这个运动。
So like our Mayapur temple here is meant for that, to give everybody all the time there should be Sankirtan and Prasadam distribution.
而 Mayapur 的这个地方的这个目的也就是这个，能够给予人们，总是能够给予人们唱诵的机会，给予人们派发 Prasadam。
So devotees shouldn't want to go to the higher planets. We shouldn't want to just go to heaven to enjoy sense gratification.
因此，奉献者不应该想要去天堂星球，不应该想要去那里做感官的感官享乐。
We definitely don't want to go if there's no devotees there. If there's no devotees there, why would we go?
当然我们肯定也 不会去，因为那里没有奉献者。如果那里没有奉献者的话，我们为什么要去那个地方呢？
And if there's no festivals for Krishna consciousness, no point to go.
那里没有 Krishna 的节日，也没有必要要去那里。
Better just to stay in the mother's womb.
最好待在这个母亲的子宫里面。
Because when you're in the mother's womb at that time, then we can meditate easily on the feet of the lotus feet of Krishna.
因为在母亲的子宫里面，人们至少可以想着主的莲花足。
But if you have to live in a place where there's no good association, then it's not auspicious.
如果一个人投身在一个没有奉献者联谊的地方，并不吉祥。
So in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, it's described the benefit of Sankirtan, that anybody who performs Sankirtan, then they please the Supreme Lord.
Chaitanya Charitamrita 描述了很多的 Sankirtan 的活动和荣耀。无论是谁，只要他举行 Sankirtan 齐颂圣名的运动，就会取悦主。
Somebody who is doing Sankirtan, then they have got very pure intelligence.
如果一个人在举行 Sankirtan 齐颂圣名的话，他一定有很纯洁的智慧。
So, there are many sacrifices mentioned in the Vedas, but Sankirtan Yajna is the highest, it's the best of all sacrifices.
在伟达文献中有很多的祭祀，提到很多的祭祀，但是举行 Sankirtan 齐颂圣名最为优秀。
Even if you do Ashwamedha Yajna, Ashwamedha Yajna is a big sacrifice, but the Sankirtan Yajna is more powerful.
即便你举行阿什瓦梅达这个祭祀，阿什瓦梅达祭祀是非常一个很大的祭祀，但是你即便举行阿什瓦梅达祭祀，也无法与 Sankirtan 祭祀相比， Sankirtan 更好。
So we cannot compare Sankirtan Yajna to any other Yajna.
我们不能拿任何一个祭祀和能与 Sankirtan 祭祀相比。
The Mayavadi people, they think Sankirtan is just a pious activity.
这些 Mayavadi 的人，他们认为 Sankirtan 只是一种虔诚活动而已。
So they think it's like, you know, just like Ashwamedha Yajna. They think it's just like that. They don't understand the transcendental nature of Sankirtan.
他们认为 Sankirtan 跟那个 Ashwamedha Yajna 一样。他们完全不理解 Sankirtan 的本性。
So to compare Sankirtan to anything material, that's offense, that's namaparad.
把 Sankirtan 和其他的任何物质相提并论，这是一种对圣名的冒犯。
It's the eighth offense. To consider chanting Hare Krishna to be a material pious activity as offered in the Vedas is karmakanda, fruit of activity.
这是圣名冒犯的第八项，认为齐颂圣名只是一种物质活动，或维达经所提到的这种祭祀活动，这是一种冒犯，对圣名的冒犯。
So chanting the holy name of the Supreme Lord never equal to any Yajna, like what the Mayavadis think.
因此，其他任何事情都不能与 Sankirtan 相提并论。
And chanting the name of the Supreme Lord Krishna or Narayan is never equal to chanting any other names.
唱诵主 Krishna 的圣名或 Narayana 的圣名，也不是和其他的圣名呀，就是其他的名字也不能和唱诵 Krishna 和 Narayana 的名字相提并论。
That's the second offense in chanting the holy name. To consider the names of the demigods like Lord Shiva or Lord Brahma to be equal to or independent of the name of Lord Vishnu.
这是圣名冒犯的第二项。如果认为唱诵这些半神如主 Brahma、主 Shiva 的圣名跟主 Vishnu 的圣名一样的话，这也是一种冒犯。
So we have to understand the power of the chanting of the holy name.
因此我们要理解唱颂圣名的力量。
And we know when we're here in India, when you're in Bharatvars, how you can go anywhere and chant the holy name, and nobody will object. People like.
我们在巴尔塔瓦舍之地，你可以去到任何一个地方，只要你唱颂圣名，没有任何人会反对，每一个人都会喜欢。
Right, we were traveling last year in the bus, going to visit holy places.And sometimes we'd stop the bus and we'd just get down in the town and we'd do Sankirtan and so many people would all come and watch and chant with us. They like to hear, to like to watch us and to hear the Kirtan.
在去年的时候我们坐公交车我们 坐大巴去一个地方由于某种原因我们停了下来然后停下来的时候我们就在那里唱诵圣名所有人都来看我们甚至加入到我们所有人都非常喜欢我们一起唱颂圣名
other countries it's not like that they will complain they will you know they'll say get away from here you're blocking the road stop this too much noise
但是你在世界上的其他任何一个地方却不是这样的情况你去到一个地方如果这样去唱颂的话别人会觉得你骚扰的他们造成了很多的噪音造成了交通堵塞打扰到他们等等这些抱怨
So the demigods are describing more about the benefit of taking birth in Bharatvars
所以这些半神人们在又继续开始描述如果出生在巴尔塔瓦舍之地他们所将得到的益处
and they say that in Bharatvars You can do devotional service, and by doing devotional service, you get free from your karma, which keeps you in the karma keeps you in the material world.
班神们说道：“如果你能够投身在巴尔塔巴舍之地，执行奉献服务的话，那么你可以摆脱 karma 这些把你束缚在这个物质世界的这些业报。”
That karma causes us to take more births in the material world.
这些业报只是会让你在这个，只是让你把你束缚在这个物质世界。
We may have some good karma, but we have also some bad karma.
我们有一些好的业报，也有一些坏的业报。
That bad karma causes us to take birth again and again.
这些不好的业报就导致我们一次又一次的投生
takes us into the lower species of life even down to the hellish planets
比如说投生到一些低等的物种甚至更有可能会投生到地狱星球
So the demigods say that to get the human birth in Bharatvars you can do Sankirtan Yagya
安神们说道：“如果一个人投身在巴尔塔巴舍之地以人体生命的话，他就有机会可以从事 Sankirtan 的祈颂圣名 Yagya 祭祀。
But if he gets a birth in Bharatvars, the human body, but he doesn't do devotional service, then he's wasted that life. It's a great waste.”
但如果一个人投身在巴尔塔巴舍之地，却不从事奉献服务的话，他完全在浪费他的人体生命。
And his position is like that of the animals in the forest who get caught by the hunter.
他们的这个处境就像一个在森林里面的野兽将再次被猎人屠杀。
Yeah, sometimes the hunter in the forest.He will put traps to catch the animals, and if the animals are careless, then they get caught by the hunter.
如果就有些时候，这个猎人会在森林里面布下陷阱，让这些鸟兽、野兽进入到陷阱，然后对它进行猎杀。
So it's in Bharatvars, of course, that we get the opportunity. You can visit the holy places, go to see the place of where Lord Krishna appeared and where Lord Chaitanya appeared. Go to Navadvip and Vrindavan.
在 Bharatvarsha 这个地方，一个人可以轻易地举行 Sankirtan， 他也可以拜访很多的圣地，比如说 Navadvip， 比如说 Vrindavan。
And there are many pure devotees in these places to get their association and to hear from them.
而且在这个地方有很多纯粹的奉献者，我们可以在这里和他们进行联谊。
But if you follow, if you take other paths, if you follow the path of cultivating knowledge or the path of karma, then it's a lot of trouble. It's very difficult to get elevated.
但是如果一个人他发展别的其从事其别的其他的道路的话，比如说业报活动，比如说培养知识，他不会得到提升。
Just by these other processes.You're not going to go back to Godhead. You may go to the higher planets, or you may go into the Brahman, but that's not good. That's not good.
因为通过其他的一些道路，比如说培养知识、从事业报，你有可能去到天堂，甚至有可能去到 Brahman. 但是呢，这并不能让你回归守神，这也不好。
Even you go into the Brahman, you have to come back again to the material world and take birth again.
即便你融入到 Brahman, 你获得了一定的解脱，你还得再次下来，还得再次投生。
So what we want to try to do is to go back home, back to Godhead.
我们应该做的是要回归家园，回归守神。
Rather, if we don't do that, then we're just like these animals in the forest.
如果我们不朝着这个目标去做的话，我们就像这些动物一样。
Yeah, these animals, they have freedom, but they don't know how to use their freedom.
这些动物也有他们的自由，但是他们不知道如何利用他们的自由。
But a devotee, somebody who takes birth in Bharatvarsh, they should take advantage to become perfect, to go back to Godhead.
但是一位奉献者，一位能够在巴尔塔巴士之地出生的人，他应该好好的利用这一个，直接回归守身。
Other places outside Bharatvarsh, they can offer material sense enjoyment. You can get sense gratification, material pleasures, but you cannot get the same opportunity to become Krishna conscious.
在巴尔塔巴舍之地，别的地方就是以外的这些地方，你可以得到很多的物质享乐的机会和设施，但是你没法和在巴尔塔巴舍之地的这些人相比，他们可以得到 Krishna 知觉的机会。
So we see other countries outside Bharatvarsh, standard of living must be much higher. We know, but that standard of living is just sense gratification.
我们看到在巴尔塔巴舍之地之外的这些国家，他们的生活标准或许很高，但是这种生活标准只是为了感官享乐而已。
So we have to realize our human life, we have to know, we have to understand and realize that we are part and parcel of Krishna and become Krishna conscious.
作为人体生命，我们应该觉悟到，我们是 Krishna 的不可分割的一部分。
And then we're meant to distribute that knowledge around the world.
在这之后，我们应该派发这一门知识到全世界去。
Don't be a miser. Don't just keep it for yourself.
不要成为一个吝啬鬼，不要把这个知识只是自己保留着。
Just like you have the human body, don't be a miser. There's two kinds of people. There's the Brahmana and the Kripana. Kripana is a miser.
有两类人，一类是 Brahmana, 另外一类是 Kripana. Kripana 就是说吝啬鬼。
And the Brahmana, he's meant to be generous. Whatever he has, he will give.
一个婆罗门，一个 Brahmana， 他的意思是，他非常慷慨，想要给予别人。
You ask the Brahmana for something, he will not refuse, he will give it.
你向一个婆罗门要什么东西的话，这个婆罗门，这个 Brahmana， 他不会拒绝，他就会给你。
Just like Dadichi Muni, Indra came and asked him for the bones from his body, and Dadichi gave them.
就像阿迪奇穆尼，当 Indra 来的时候，他想要一个他身上的骨头，这个穆尼，这个圣人给他了。
And then another example, Dronacharya. Dronacharya taught Dhrishtadyumna how to fight.
另外一个例子是 Dronacharya, 他教授 Dhrishtadyumna, 教授他如何作战。
But Dhrishtadyumna was born to kill Drona.
而 Dhrishtadyumna, 他出生就是想要杀死 Dronacharya.
But still Drona took him as his student and agreed to teach him.
但是 Dhrishtadyumna 是一个老师，他就是要教授。
Yeah, he said, he's come to me for teaching, I cannot refuse him.
他来到这儿想学东西，我不能拒绝。
So, that's the generosity of the Brahmana.
这就是 Brahmana 的慷慨仁慈。
So, in India, there are many people who worship demigods.
在印度有很多的人崇拜半神人。
And people worship these demigods. Some people worship the demigods as part and parcel of the Supreme Lord.
有一些人崇拜半神人，他们会认为这些半神人是至尊主的部分，整体的部分，所属部分。
So if they worship the demigods like that, then Krishna will accept their offerings.
如果他们崇拜半神人带着这样的一种观念的话，至尊人格守神会接受这种供奉。
And he'll gradually bring these people who are worshipping like this, he'll gradually bring them to the proper standard of devotional service.
如果这些人是这样的一种态度的话，而且至尊主就会逐渐将这些崇拜者提升到奉爱服务的真正的标准上。
Yeah. Because Krishna is complete,So he'll give everything to these worshippers. He will satisfy their desires.
因为主 Krishna 是完整的，他会满足这些人的愿望。
Yeah, they're worshipping, and they have some desires.
他们崇拜是带着一定的愿望，一定的渴望的。
But they are only worshipping part of his body.
但是他们只是崇拜了至尊主的身体的一部分而已。
But Krishna understands they're worshipping me, so okay, accept them.
虽然他们只是崇拜了 Krishna 的一部分身体，但是 Krishna 也理解，他觉得好吧，就满足他们。
That is Krishna's mercy.
这是主 Krishna 的仁慈。
Just like Putana, she came to Krishna, and she came dressed very nicely.And she was dressed like a gopi, you know, very beautiful, with nice jewelry and everything, and makeup, and looked very nice. And everyone thought, oh, what a nice gopi. They didn't know she was Putana.
就像 Putana, 那个想杀死 Krishna 的女巫，她穿得非常的美丽，打扮得像一个牧牛姑娘们一样，牧牛姑娘一样，她接近 Krishna, 所有人都认为哦，这是一个很好的牧牛姑娘，他们不知道她却是 Putana。
So she had come to kill Krishna, and she wanted to give her she had put poison on her breast and wanted to feed it to Krishna to kill him.
她想要杀死这个 Putana, 想要杀死 Krishna, 她把这个毒液放在她的乳房上，然后想给 Krishna 喂奶的时候就杀死 Krishna。
So of course Krishna killed her.But he also took her to the spiritual world to be his mother in the spiritual world.
虽然 Krishna 最后杀死了她，仍然她这个 Putana 被提升到灵性世界作为她的母亲。
Yeah, not directly his mother, but like a nurse, you know, a nurse who takes care of the baby.
不是一个直接的母亲，就像一个护士或者说一个奶妈一样。
So this is the special mercy of Krishna.
这是主 Krishna 特别的仁慈之处。
Because he sees, she wants to be a devotee. She's dressed like a devotee, and she's coming to give me milk, and wants to feed her breast. I'll take her back to Godhead.
主 Krishna 是这么想的，哦，这个人穿得像一个奉献者一样，他肯定想成为一个奉献者，他还想给我喂奶，那好吧，就把他带到灵性世界吧。
So there's different kinds of devotees we see. Some devotees worship Krishna directly, and other people, they worship Krishna as, you know, as like through the demigods, the different parts. And think of the demigods as different parts of Krishna.
我们看到有不同的奉献者，有一些奉献者他是直接的崇拜 Krishna。有一些奉献者他是通过崇拜半世人来崇拜 Krishna， 他认为半世人是 Krishna 的一部分，他们这样崇拜着 Krishna。
And when they're worshipping these demigods, they're worshipping to get some benediction. They want to get something from these demigods.
当他们这样去崇拜半世人的时候，他们是想从半世人那里得到一些好处。
So in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says people who worship demigods,they're not very intelligent.
So Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中说，那些崇拜半世人们的人，并不十分有智慧。
Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, "Antavatu phalam tesham tad bhavati alpamedasham." Krishna is describing that the results of worshipping demigods will be limited and temporary.
Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中说。那些崇拜半世人们的人，他们得到的结果非常的短暂而且有限。
And people who do this worship are not intelligent.
而他们做这种崇拜的人并不十分有智慧。
They're described as Alpa Medasaha. Medasaha means intelligent and Alpa means very, very small intelligence.
他们的智慧非常非常的小，非常非常的小。
But devotees who do Sankirtan, they're described as Sumedasaha. Medasaha means intelligence, and Sum means very auspicious, very good intelligence.
而奉献者，那些从事 Sankirtan 的奉献者们被描述为 Sumedasaha。Medasaha 是智慧的意思， Sum 是特别。他们这些从事 Sankirtan 的奉献者是特别特别有智慧的人。
You can see the difference. So somebody is worshipping the demigods, that's indirectly.
那些崇拜半神们的人，所以我们可以看到他们之间的区别。那些崇拜半神们的人，他们是非常间接的。
But the devotees, they directly worship Krishna.
但是奉献者们是直接的在崇拜 Krishna.
We worship Krishna through the Sankirtan movement and through very staunch bhakti yoga.
奉献者们崇拜 Krishna 是通过奉爱瑜伽，通过 Sankirtan.
So it's not Krishna's desire to be worshipped indirectly through the different parts of the demigods.
Krishna 不希望通过躯体不同部分的被间接的得到崇拜。
Yeah, Krishna would prefer that the devotee directly worships him.
Krishna 更喜欢那些奉献者们直接崇拜他。
And if they worship Krishna directly, then quickly they can come to the transcendental platform.
如果那些奉献者们直接的崇拜他们的话，他们会非常直接的、立刻的，而且迅速的达到一种超然的层面。
But the people who are worshipping the demigods as parts of Krishna, they also get their benedictions.
那些崇拜主不同部分的，比如说崇拜半神的人，那些奉献者，他们会得到一些赐福。
Not difficult for Krishna to give their benedictions.
对于 Krishna 来说，要给一些祝福，要给一些赐福，并不困难。
But he very rarely gives pure devotion. That's something very special.
但是对于主来说，他非常罕见的把纯粹的奉爱服务给予某人，这是非常特殊的。
Krishna won't give pure devotion because he becomes conquered and controlled by those who've got that pure devotion.
Krishna 不想给予纯粹的奉爱给予一个人，是因为这个纯粹的奉爱能够把 Krishna 给征服给束缚住。
Just like we know, Mother Yashoda tied up Krishna.
我们知道主我们知道亚瑟的妈妈把主 Krishna 给绑了起来。
And Arjuna, he had to become the Arjuna took Krishna as his chariot driver, Krishna to drive his chariot in the battle.
我们还知道 Arjuna 让 Krishna 来做他的马车夫，啊，这个 Krishna 在还带着这个 Arjuna 在这个战场上。
So Krishna will fulfill the desires of people who come to him with some material desire.
那些有愿望的人 ,Krishna 会满足他的愿望。
But he won't give desires that will cause them to come again and again to him.
但是他不会给他的这他不会满足他的这个愿望。会导致他一次又一次的来找他。
Right, you know, somebody gets something one time, they think, wow, I got what I wanted, I'm going to worship Krishna again, and you come with more, and you keep coming every week with a big list of what you want. So Krishna doesn't like that.
Krishna 并不喜欢这样，比如说一个人他找 Krishna 要东西，要了之后他又得到之后他又想要更多，然后又去找 Krishna 又要更多。Krishna 并不喜欢这种。
So Krishna will take away these desires by giving us something, by giving us pure devotion.
Krishna 会通过给予奉爱服务的方式把这种愿望给拿走。
Krishna can take away these material desires of the devotees.
Krishna 可以把奉献者的物质愿望给拿走。
And the devotee won't desire anything. He won't have any more material desires.
然后这个奉献者再也没有物质愿望了。
So that is the special mercy of Krishna.
这是主 Krishna 特别的仁慈之处。
So this is in the Srimad in the second canto Srimad Bhagavatam.It was already stated that even if you have all material desires or no material desires, still we should worship the Supreme.
在圣典博迦瓦坛第二篇有这样的一个描述，无论一个人是有物质愿望，充满的物质愿望，还是没有物质愿望，他都应该崇拜至尊者。
And even if you want to become one with the Supreme, you should do devotional service.
即便一个人他想和至尊主合一，他也应当从事奉献服务。
And if they do devotional service, then it will happen that gradually they'll have no other desire than want. They will just simply want to do devotional service.
如果一个人从事奉献服务的话，结果是逐渐的，他不再会有这些物质愿望。只是想做奉献服务了。
Because it's the nature of devotional service that the more you do it, the less you want anything. You don't want, you lose your interest in other things.
这就是奉献服务的本性。你越是从事奉献服务，你就会越失去对其他事情的兴趣。
So if we come to Krishna with some material desire, then.Krishna will arrange that gradually we will become a devotee without material, we'll have no material desire. Krishna will take away the desires.
比如说你开始的时候有一些物质愿望去到 Krishna 那里，然后你在从事奉献服务，逐渐的你就没有这些物质愿望。
Just want to do devotional service, just want to serve Krishna.
你只是想从事奉献服务，只是想服务 Krishna.
Doesn't want anything else. That is the highest stage of devotional service.
你不再想要任何其他的东西，而且达到了一种很高的奉爱服务的层面。
So Krishna satisfies the desires of the devotee so that he will lose all of his material desires.
Krishna 通过 满足一个奉献者的愿望，最后让他变得失去所有的物质愿望。
Just like Dhruva Maharaj, he was a devotee, and he went to the forest to get a kingdom. He wanted a kingdom greater than his father.
就像 Dhruva Maharaj, 他的愿望是得到比他父亲更好的一个王国，于是他去到森林。
And so he met Narada Muni, and Narada Muni gave him some instructions, and so Dhruva Maharaj started to do his austerities.
然后他遇到了 Narada Muni, Narada Muni 给了他一些训示，他开始从事一些苦行。
And he was doing austerities and fasting and standing on one leg and controlling his breathing.
他开始单脚站立，戒食，然后控制呼吸。
He stopped eating, he stopped drinking, and he was controlling his breathing.
他不吃不喝，控制着呼吸。
And he was chanting, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
然后开始唱诵着 Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
And then the Lord appeared. He came riding on the back of Garuda. After 6 months, after Dhruva Maharaj had been there for 6 months, then the Lord appeared on the back of Garuda.
当六个月之后，主本人就显现了，他就坐在 Garuda 的背上。
So when Dhruva Maharaj saw the Lord on the back of Garuda, then he realized he didn't want anything. He forgot all his material desires.
当 Dhruva Maharaj 看到主坐在哪儿，坐在 Garuda 的背上的时候，他发现他再也不想要其他的任何物质愿望。
He says, I just want to serve your lotus feet. I don't want anything.
我只想服务您的莲花足，我再也不想要任何其他的事情。
Just like sometimes the little baby, they put something in their mouth. They may put some stone or some dirt in their mouth.
就像一个小孩，他吃脏东西，这个东西上他想吃一些石头啊，或者一些有灰尘的东西。
So the mother will be very concerned, and she'll tell the child, "Take these things out your mouth, and I will give you some nice sweet. I'll give you some burfi or some mahaprasadam."
然后这个母亲就跟这个小孩说，把你手上的这个脏东西拿开，我给你另外一个好吃的东西，比如说 burfi 啊，比如说 mahaprasadam。
So like that, devotional service is like that. It's more, it's something better than what we've got at the moment.
所以奉爱服务就是这样的，它比我们在那个时候的东西要好。
So a devotee who wants material desires, who wants some material blessings from Krishna, they're like children.
就像刚刚我们举到的这个例子，奉献者想要这些物质愿望，就像这个小孩想要吃脏东西一样。
But Krishna is very kind. He takes away the material desires and gives them the best thing.
主 Krishna 非常的仁慈，他拿走这些奉献者的物质愿望，然后给予他最好的事情。
But we just simply have to worship Krishna and engage in his devotional service, and all our desires can be fulfilled.
因此我们只应该崇拜 Krishna, 崇拜 Krishna, 然后 崇拜 Krishna, 对他做奉爱服务，然后我们所有的愿望都会满足。
Krishna thinks that he thinks that this person, he's my devotee, but he's coming to me for sense gratification. It's like asking for poison instead of asking for nectar.
Krishna 会这么想，这是我的奉献者，他来到我这儿想要的是毒药而不是甘露。
So Krishna thinks, why should I give him poison? I want to give him nectar.
Krishna 会想，我为什么要给他毒药呢？我想要给他甘露。
Why should I give him some material enjoyment? Let me give him the shelter at my lotus feet.
为什么我要给这个人物质享乐的这些东西呢？让我给他我的莲花足的庇护。
So Krishna says, I will help him to forget all his material desires.
Krishna 说，我会帮助这个人忘掉所有的物质愿望。
So if he does like this, gradually the devotee will forget his material desires and he will just want to worship Krishna.
因此，如果奉献者这么做的话，逐渐的他就会忘掉他所有的物质愿望，然后得到 Krishna 莲花足的庇护。
So Lord Chaitanya says like that also in Shikshastikam. He says that I only want your I don't want wealth or women or followers. I only want your devotional service, birth after birth.
主 Chaitanya 在这个八旬归中也这么说，说道：我不想要追随者，我不想要财富。我只想要对您莲花族一世又一世的奉爱服务。
Okay. So, wait, there's just one more prayer. And we'll just finish it. So the demigods are saying, we're living in the heavenly planets because of our pious activities.
这些半神们继续祈祷道，我们在天堂星球，这肯定是我们前世从事了虔诚活动的原因。
But we know that one day our life here will be finished. We have to leave here.
但是我们也知道，有一天我们的生命也会在这里终结。
So we just pray that when we have to leave here, that we could take our birth in Bharatvarsha as human beings and be able to remember the lotus feet of the Lord.
因此我们祈祷，在那个我们要离开的时候，我们能够投身在巴尔塔巴舍之地，能够记忆主的莲花足。
Because we know that sometimes the Lord is so kind that he personally comes there and has his pastimes there. So we would like to be there at that.
因为我们知道主非常的仁慈，他有时候会亲自去到巴尔塔巴舍之地，因此我们也想去到那里。
So the demigods understood the temporary nature of their life in the heavenly planets, and they know they have to leave there.
这些半神们知道在天堂星球的本性，就是说到了一定的时候，他们也得离开那里。
So they're praying that somehow if we can get to come to Bharatvarsha, then that would be the best place.
他们祈祷，他们希望也能够投身在巴尔塔巴舍之地，那是最好的地方。
And the demigods pray that they have enough piety left, because they use their piety to go to heaven. So they just pray that we still have some piety left to take birth in Bharatvarsha.
半神们祈祷道，如果因为他们去天堂星球的时候是通过虔诚活动，在虔诚活动最后留下一点点的时候，他们希望用这点虔诚活动让他们能够投身在巴尔塔巴舍之地。
So if he can somehow take his birth there, then he can become Krishna conscious. And if he becomes Krishna conscious, he can go back to Godhead very easily.
如果他们能够投身在巴尔塔巴舍之地，他们就会有 Krishna 知觉。如果他们发展了 Krishna 知觉，他们能够很轻易的就回归守神，重返家园。
So you can see the demigods, they want to come to take birth in Bharatvarsha. If somebody on earth wants to go to heaven, then they're foolish.
我们会发现这些半神人们都在祈祷，想要来到巴尔塔巴舍之地，而这些想要去到天堂星球的人是多么的愚蠢。
So that birth in Bharatvarsha is so special, it's such a great opportunity. You should take full advantage.
因此投身在巴尔塔巴舍之地非常的幸运， 应该充分地利用这个机会。
So this is the mercy of Lord Chaitanya to make us all aware of the value of a birth in Bharatvarsh.
所以这就是投身在巴尔塔巴舍之地的荣耀。
And by the mercy of the Krishna consciousness movement, more people are getting the opportunity to become Krishna conscious.
而通过 Krishna 知觉的这个发展，由于这个 Krishna 知觉的发展，很多的人得到了这个机会和仁慈。
And they can get association with pure devotees in the Krishna consciousness movement, and they can become Krishna conscious, and they can go back to Godhead.
我们也可以利用 Krishna 知觉这个运动和很多的纯粹奉献者联谊，通过这个 Krishna 知觉的运动，我们也可以回归守身。
So this is the prayers of the demigods.
所以这是半世人们的祈祷。
Glorifying the land of Bharatvarsha.
荣耀巴尔塔巴舍之地。
And Bharatvarsha is just that one part, one tiny part, one small part of Jambadvip.
Bharatvarsha 只是 Jambadvip 的一个小部分。
Okay, are there any questions?
Yes. Yes, first question from Hani Vamsa. Dimbai, 亲爱的 Guru, 这两天高烧感冒，呼吸有点困难，喉咙多龙痰，都是躺在床上休息。突然我与妻子商量一下，演练下怎么开始离开躯体。我要求读 Krishna 的故事，我妻子读的是 Krishna 的日常生活，在 Dwarka 宫殿的生活。可我的心意更喜欢稳当的 Krishna 与木流姑娘的逍遥时光。是不是如果真离开躯体，要与守护人交代清楚？我感觉手机提示声和儿子的声音也会有打扰专注，是不是应该远离这些打扰？还是个问题，我们是感恩主 Brahma 赐予的人体自愈力 ，Brahmana 赐予的人体自愈力，还是要相信薄伽梵歌所说的人体的四大缺陷有自愈力，但并不完美。obeisance to dear Guru. These days I get cold and I can't breathe. And when I breathe, I have difficulty, so I just have rest on the bed. Suddenly, I ask my wife to performance how to leave the body. So I ask her to read the Krishna's stories, but my wife read the Krishna's daily times like the pastime in the Dwarka. But my mind more like theKrishna pastime in Vrindavan with the cowboys. So I want to ask whether when we leave the body, we should say to our family very clearly what they should do. This is the first question.
Well, yes, ideally.If you know, when you leave the body, really probably it will be difficult to focus on hearing someone read. It's better to have kirtan. We give, you know, much more importance to the chanting of the holy name at that particular time.
当然，是的，在离开躯体的时候，我们是很难以专注于聆听，Krishna 的一些逍遥时光。最好的是做 kirtan， 让我们的心意，让我们在那个时候能够聆听到 Krishna 的圣名。
Today we were speaking also, you heard the glories of the Sankirtan, that you do Sankirtan Yagya. It's so much, 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 much more greater than any other kind of sacrifice. It's not material, it's a transcendental activity.
今天我们也聆听到了很多有关 Sankirtan 的荣耀。 我们在临死临离开躯体的那个时候，如果周围的人从事这个 Sankirtan 的话，那是更好更好更好的这个祭祀，比其他的方法都要好。
And so we know from Srila Prabhupada's time also, when Prabhupada was leaving the body, he wanted kirtan.
我们回顾这个圣帕帕德离开躯体的时候，圣帕帕德在离开躯体之前，他希望奉献着 kirtan 唱诵。
Yeah, he would always like to have devotees come and chant for him. Sometimes they would have reading, sometimes, but more it was kirtan.
圣帕帕德总是希望有奉献者来那里唱诵，有一些时候可能有一些时候是阅读一些是经典，但是更多更多的时候都是 kirtan。
Because you're leaving the body, you're not in a very comfortable position. It's not a very comfortable situation. And the best thing is to hear the holy name, the loud chanting of the holy name.
因为在离开躯体的之前的那个时刻，你的身体并不很舒服，所以更好的方式是大声的聆听，大声的唱诵主的圣名。
The loud chanting of the holy name creates the most auspicious atmosphere.
大声的唱诵圣名能够创造最好的气氛环境氛围。
Okay.
Next, he asked, I feel the noise from the phone, the mobile phone, and my son's noise. They also disturb my meditation and focus. So, whether should I ask them to go away?And not disturb me at that time.
Oh, the time you're leaving the body?
Yeah. He's also imagined when he leave the body, whether he should ask her,
yes,
disturb me.
Definitely you want to get rid of your mobile phone at that time.
肯定的，你在那个时候一定要把你的手机拿开。
Get rid of that long before you leave the body.
在你离开躯体的时候，不要让你的手机打扰你。
And children also, it's not very appropriate to have children there at the time of leaving the body.
在离开躯体的时候，让小孩子在那里也不是很好的，那个也会影响。
Generally.You don't want women there also when you leave the body. A man, you don't want to leave the body in the presence of women. You want to be with other men.
如果是一个男的的话，他在离开躯体的时候，最好也不要有太多的，也不要有女士在内，也不要有 Mataji 在内。
Because, well, it's just, this is,If women are there, then women can attract the attention. You don't want to be attracted to women at the time of death.
因为你在那个时候不想被女性的这种吸引力拿走你的注意力，你在死的时候不要把你的注意力分散到这些女性的身上。
So, you want to leave the body with men. Let some men take care of you.
你让一些男的来照顾你，在那个时候照顾你。
Go ahead.
And he asked, about the silk. Whether should we, thanks to the Brahma, give us the self-recovery power, or we should trust the Bhagavad Gita, because the human body have four major defects.The self healing are not perfect. Some are confused.
I don't know what's the. I can. Can you say it again?
我们是要感恩主 Brahma 给予我们这个人体的康复力，还是要？He said the Brahma give us the recovering power.
Uh-huh.
But in the Bhagavad Gita, they said the human body have four defects.
Four defects? What are these? Make mistakes in perfect senses like that?
Yes.
Okay.
So whether the recovery power is the recovery power is perfect or not perfect? I also am confused about this.
The recovery
question.
Power. What recover what?
From the silkness.
From the what?
From the silk.
The silk.
Means we get cold and silk.
Sick.
Yeah. Sick. Get ill.
Okay. So if we get better, what I don't understand.
我们,
we get better, we get sick, but we recover.
Yeah, he said this recover power is by given by the Brahma.
Oh, really?
I don't know.
Well, I don't know. I don't know about that recovery power by Brahma. I thought it was by Krishna.
我不知道这个自愈力是不是Brahma给予的。 我觉得这个自愈力应该是主 Krishna给予的。
We say everyone lives by the grace of Krishna, and we die also by the grace of Krishna.
我们每一个人生活是生存下来是 Krishna, 我们死也是 Krishna.
No, Brahma is a servant of Krishna.
Brahma 只是主 Krishna 的一个仆人。
So recovery power, you may say Brahma is given the power by the grace of Krishna to help somebody recover, maybe.
或许这个主 Krishna 给予这个 Brahma 的力量, 让主 Brahma 给予一些人康复, 可能, 也许, 有可能是这样。
So what's the question?
Actually, I don't understand.
Tadavanti shishama, meowanti.
Tati Mataji, 你能帮一下忙吗?
Hare Krishna, good day. 他是Harivansa Prabhu, 他是想说, 就是人体的这个四大缺陷, 我们应该相信布达邦哥的说的，我们人应该有四大缺陷嘛，就是容易被迷惑，然后总是有欺骗的倾向，就是这四个不完美的地方。然后他说我们是应该相信这四个不完美的地方，还是应该就是觉得感恩主那布拉玛给予我们这个自愈的能力。 我们有没有这个自愈的能力？我们没有。自己的身体能好起来。
Devotee just depends on Krishna.
奉献者只是依靠 Krishna.
We don't think about getting power by Brahma or from Brahma or anything. Brahma is also a jiva. He's also a living entity in the universe. He's not God.
我们不是去感谢 Brahma. Brahma 他也是一个生物，他是由主给予的。
So Brahma also sometimes makes mistakes. Brahma also, we have Brahma Vimohan Lila in 10th canto Srimad Bhagavatam.
我们有 Brahma 为摩诃尼拉 Brahma 也会犯错误。
Brahma tried to understand the greatness of Krishna and he realized it was a great mistake.
Brahma 那个时候偷走的这个奶牛故事他对 Krishna 做出了一个冒犯。
So, devotee just surrenders to Krishna. If Krishna wants us to recover, then it can happen.
奉献者只是臣服于 Krishna. 如果 Krishna 让我们能够恢复的话，那就恢复。
Okay.
Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Bindu Madhava, 百长青。Obeisance to Guru, 感谢主持人和翻译。请问 Japa 和 Kirtan 为什么会被称为奉献服务呢？如果我们不停地念着某个人的名字，这个人一定会觉得被骚扰和打扰很烦，哪里会有快乐可言啊？Okay, obeisance to Guru Dev. I want to ask why the Japa and Kirtan are called devotional service.Because, for example, when we chant, when we constantly chant someone's name, maybe this one will be disturbed and will feel boring, and he will not feel happiness. So why this japa and kirtan are called devotional service?
Well, you have to understand chanting Krishna's name is not like chanting anybody else's name.Krishna's name is transcendental.
你得理解，唱诵 Krishna 的名字跟唱诵其他人的名字是不一样的。Krishna 的名字是超然的。
Yeah, if we chant somebody's material name, that will certainly be boring. Yeah, we'll get fed up, but people will get tired of hearing it.
如果我们唱诵一个世俗之人的名字，我们自己也会唱得很厌烦。别人也会听着很累。
But the nature of Krishna's name is a very different experience. That the more we chant, the more we get pleasure.
但是 Krishna 的名字是非常不同的体验。我们越多的唱诵，会有越多的快乐。
Because the holy name of Krishna is not different from Krishna.
因为 Krishna 的圣名跟 Krishna 本人没有区别。
The holy name is described in the scriptures as being Chintamani. It can fulfill all of our desires.
Krishna 的名字在经典被描述为 Chintamani, 点睛石，可以满足人所有的愿望。
And the holy name is it's Chintamani. It's Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha. It's the form of rasa.And it's full of consciousness.
这个圣名是充满着 rasa, 充满着知觉的，充满着品味的。
Purna
Shuddho. 它是这个 rasa 的形体。
It's Purna Shuddho. It's completely pure and complete, completely pure.
它是完全纯洁的。
Nitya Muktam. It's eternally liberated.
它是 Nitya Mukta 是完全永恒的解脱的。
And Binat Nam Nama Namano, it's not different from Krishna himself, the person of the name.
这个 Krishna 的圣名和 Krishna 个人本人没有任何的区别。
Are you going to get bored if you're with Krishna? Do you think it's boring to be around Krishna all the time?
你认为你在 Krishna 的身边总是在打扰吗？
No, it's the most ecstasy, it's the greatest ecstasy to be with Krishna.
这是非常大的狂喜和 Krishna 在一起。
So when we're with the holy name, we should experience also the ecstasy of the holy name.
当我们和圣明在一起的时候，我们也应该感觉到狂喜。Gurudev, maybe he asked, maybe like the ordinary people, they hear others chanting his name, he feel boring. Maybe Bindu Madhava ask, maybe we chant the Lord's name, maybe Lord feel boring.
Who are boring?
The Lord.
The Lord is bored by us chanting his name? No, he takes pleasure in hearing his name.
不，他由于我们唱诵他的名字，他会获得快乐。
Lord Krishna himself said, he said, Naham tishtani vaikunte yoginam ridayeshuva tatra tishtani narada yatra gayanti madbhakta. Krishna said, I am not in the hearts of the yogis meditating on me, and I am not in Vaikuntha.
主 Krishna 亲自说，我不在瑜伽师冥想的心中，我也不在外昆塔。
But I am wherever my devotees, like Narada, are chanting my holy name.
我在我的奉献者，比如像 Narada 这样的人的奉献者，那你在唱诵我的圣名之中。
Lord Krishna is attracted by pure devotion. Pure devotion is what Krishna wants. So when you chant the name purely, then you attract Krishna, you give pleasure to Krishna.
Krishna 喜欢我们的纯粹的奉献服务。如果我们能够纯粹的唱诵 Krishna 的圣名的话， Krishna 是被吸引的。
Why does Radharani attract Krishna?
为什么 Radharani 能够吸引 Krishna 呢？
It's not just her good looks.
不仅仅是因为她美丽，看上去好看。
It's her mood of service, her loving devotion.
是她奉献服务的心态。
So Krishna takes pleasure in the love of his devotees.
Krishna 非常被他的这些奉献者的爱所取悦。
Krishna thinks these devotees love me so much.
Krishna 会认为这些奉献者那么的爱我。
So Krishna enjoys having relationships with these devotees. He enjoys their company.
Krishna 非常享受和这些奉献者的在一起，非常享受这些奉献者的陪伴。
And the devotees take pleasure in being with Krishna.
而且奉献者也非常，在跟 Krishna 在一起的时候也非常的快乐。
When Krishna left Vrindavan, all the gopis, they were heartbroken.
当 Krishna 离开 Vrindavan 的时候，所有的物流姑娘们心都碎了。
Mother Yashoda never stopped crying after Krishna left.
当 Krishna 离开之后，亚修达母亲从来没有停止过哭泣。
Because they have so much love for Krishna, and that love is ecstasy.
他有太多对 Krishna 的爱，而这种爱是很狂喜的。
We have not got the experience of this kind of love.We only know about the material relationships.
我们没有这种跟 Krishna 的这种纯粹的爱，我们有的是这种物质的关系。
You're using your material judgment to try to estimate the nature of relationships with Krishna.
你用的是物质的这种人和人之间的关系来评判人们和 Krishna 的关系。
Yeah, because in material world we get tired of hearing your name. Somebody, you know, if your wife is always calling your name, you get tired.
你用的是一种物质的眼光去评判，在物质的世界上，我们确实听到某人喊我们，比如说你的妻子在不停的叫你的时候，你觉得很烦。
But it's a different experience in the spiritual world.
但是这个体验在灵性世界是完全不一样的。
We have to understand more the nature of Krishna's holy name.
因此，我们应该更多的去理解 Krishna 的圣名的 本性。
And how much Krishna loves his devotees.
然后要更多的去理解 Krishna 是如何有多么去多么的爱他的奉献。
Because the devotees gave everything for Krishna. Krishna cannot repay them.
因为奉献者把所有的一切都给予了 Krishna, Krishna 都还不起。
Alright, 还有问题。Some other question?
还有 yes, from Chandra Vinasi, Madhaji, 虔诚的顶拜 Guru 甜美的莲花组顶拜翻译顶拜所有的奉献者请教 Guru 您讲到的 Krishna 会拿走我们的物质愿望那在做早课的时候还需要向 Krishna 祈祷拿走自己的物质愿望吗 Obeisance to Guru's sweet lotus feet, you mentioned that Krishna will take away our material desire.When we do the morning arti, should we also pray to the Lord, to the Krishna, please take away our material desire?
Yes, if you like, you can do that.
如果你想的话，你可以继续这么祈祷，可以做。
Krishna will certainly be happy to do that.
Krishna.也会高兴如果你做这个的话、
mm-hmm. yes.
Next question.
Yes.
Next question from Hanivamsa. The Pakistan and Indonesia also from Bharatvarsha.
Bharatvarsha, yes, of course, India has been greatly reduced in recent years.So yes, Bharatvarsha was much more than just what we call India.
当然 Bharatvarsha, 印度它本身的土地已经有很多的削减，就是说 Bharatvarsha 之地有很多削减。Bharatvarsha 之地肯定是超过印度的这个现有的范围。
So it previously would include places like Pakistan and Sri Lanka and Burma and.Other side also, Bangladesh, these places are all part of Bharatvarsha.
在先前的这个印度，它肯定，比如说巴基斯坦，比如说斯里兰卡，比如说孟加拉国，这些也属于Bharatvarsha之地。
Mm-hmm.
Can you ask Indonesia?
Indonesia.Well, Vedic culture is there. Vedic culture is certainly there in Indonesia. We see a lot of Vedic culture, the Mahabharata and everything is well known. All the Muslim people there, they're all familiar with the Mahabharata and Ramayana.
在印度尼西亚那里也有很多的那里也有伟大的文化比如说 Mahabharata, 那里的穆斯林们他们都知道 Mahabharata.
In the past, Indonesia was, they were all Hindus, but you know, later on the kings married and they became Muslims, so everybody was converted to Mohammedan.
在之前，印度尼西亚有很多的印度人，但是呢，当那个国王结婚，然后就成为了穆斯林，所有的人也变成了穆斯林。
不是印度人，他们是信印度教。本地人信印度教。
对，不好意思，对不起。在那之前，很多人都是信印度教的。但是呢，当国王结婚成为穆斯林之后，他们的臣民也转变为穆斯林。
And only one part of Indonesia, there was one part Bali. Those people, they wouldn't change. They remained Hindu.
在印度尼西亚，只有一个地方。就是在巴厘岛那个地方，那里的人们还没有转变，他们还在信印度教。
But I don't know if it was part of Bharatvarsha. May have been.
我不知道这个 Bharatvarsha 有没有这个印度尼西亚。
Thailand also a lot of Vedic culture there.
泰国也有很多的伟大的文化。
Prabhupada said, in Thailand, the Vedic culture is there for sense gratification, not for religion, not for emancipation, but for sense gratification.
深怕怕地说，在泰国的伟大文化是为了感官享乐的，不是为了这个解脱的。
OK， 还有问题？
From Sivata Saki， 顶拜 Guru， 感谢翻译。我的问题是，供奉 Prasada 的正确方法有几个说法，我有一些茫然。You want to know the offering Prasada the right ways? What are the right ways?I heard some ways, but I feel confused.
So what does she want to know? The prayers, the mantras to chant?
您是想问这个唱诵的曼陀罗的吗？还是想问是在供奉菩萨等中的什么东西？ She didn't mention.
Yeah, I know. Well, generally, you should have a plate, which is...for the deity, a special plate which is not used by anybody else, and you put the food to be offered on that plate.
通常情况下，你要有一个供奉给神像的单独的一个盘子，这个盘子不是被其他人所用过的，然后把食物放在这个盘子上。
And then you should have a tosi leaf or part of a tosi leaf to put on each preparation.
然后把图罗拉西叶放在这个供奉每一样供奉的食物之上。
And then you should do Akshman, purify yourself.
然后
chant Akshman.
然后你做这个 Akshman 就是净化仪式，净化你自己，唱诵曼陀罗。
And then you have to chant three prayers. First, you chant to the Guru three times.
然后你开始唱诵祷文，首先是唱诵你咕噜的祷文三次
，along with Prabhupada's mantra，
然后是圣帕帕德的曼陀罗
，and then you chant to the Lord Chaitanya，
然后唱诵给主 Chaitanya 的祷文
，three times，
三次
，and then you chant， so you can chant。After you chant to the Guru, you can chant Panchatattva mantra three times, and then you can chant Hare Krishna mantra three times.
在唱诵完Guru 的这个祷文之后，你可以唱诵 Panchatattva 三次，然后唱诵 Hare Krishna 三次。
Right, and sometimes other people who are more advanced, they may want to chant to the Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu directly.Namo Mahabhadanaya Krishna Prima, like that. And after chant to Lord Chaitanya, then you chant to the Brahmanas. Namo Brahmana Devaya, Go Brahmana Hitaya Cha. They don't chant Hare Krishna or Sri Krishna Chaitanya. They just chant these other prayers.
当然也有一些人他们不唱诵这个加须 Krishna 和这个 Hare Krishna, 他们直接唱诵这个给主 Chaitanya 的和给这个 Brahmana 的这两个部分的祷文。
And while you're offering the food, nobody should look. You should close the curtain, or you should have something in front of the altar.
当你在供奉食物的时候，没有人应该不让别人看见。你应该拿起这个帘子，或者说有一个什么帘东西挡着。
Or have everybody go out of the room into another room.
或者别人会从这个房间离开去到其他的房间。
And the offering should take whatever time you're allowed. It should maybe 5 minutes or 10 minutes, sometimes even 15 minutes.
然后你就供奉的时间，有时候是5分钟，有时候10分钟，有时候15分钟，根据你自己所能允许的时间，就是说根据你的情况。
Okay, any other question?
Yeah, last question. Guru Mani, Mataji, 顶拜 Guru, 感谢主持翻译。为什么孟加拉的 Navadvipa 是最佳之地，而不提 Mathura 的 Vrindavan 是最佳之地？ Why the Navadvipa is the best place, but not the Vrindavan?
Because Navadvipa is the place where Lord Chaitanya appeared, and Lord Chaitanya is the most merciful of all of Krishna's incarnations.
因为 Navadvipa 是主 Chaitanya 降生地，而主 Chaitanya 是 Krishna 所有化身中最仁慈的。
And you go to Vrindavan, you have to be very careful, Because you make any offenses in Vrindavan, you get heavy reactions.
因为你去 Vrindavan, 你得很小心。如果你在 Vrindavan 做出冒犯的话，你得有很严重的惩罚。
But if you're in Mayapur, you get a lot of mercy from Lord Chaitanya.
如果你在 Mayapur 的话，你会得到主 Chaitanya 很多的仁慈。
So that's why Mayapur Navadvipa is the best of all the places.
这就是为什么说 Navadvipa 的 Mayapur 是所有之地最好的地方。
That's why Prabhupada made the headquarters for ISKCON here.
圣帕帕德把 ISKCON 的总部也放在了 Mayapur。
He knows we need mercy. We need the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
圣帕帕德知道我们需要仁慈，我们需要主 Chaitanya 的仁慈。
嗯哼。还有问题吗
？No, finished.
Finished. 真的吗
？Yes.这一次没有了。
Oh, okay. Sati.
Hare Krishna. Gurudev. 周二我们还剩了一个问题，然后您可以回答一下。
可以。
是庞继东，牡丹江的一位奉献者。Krishna 的伟大奉献者。永恒的同游是 Krishna 创造的，还是他们一世复一世修习来的
？Oh yeah.
The Lord, the internal source association are created by the Krishna, or they practiced by many lifetimes.
Well, they are all eternal associates of Krishna.
他们都是主永恒的同友。
They're all Krishna's internal potency.
他们都是主 Krishna 永恒的内在的能量。
Yeah, they're not sadhana siddha. It's not that they became perfect by sadhana. No, they're nitya siddha.
他们不是 sadhana siddha, 就是说不是通过规范修习而来的。他们是永恒的。永恒的完美界人
Eternally devotees.
他们是永恒的奉献者。
And they have the powers almost like Krishna. They can expand themselves.
他们几乎有 Krishna 一样的力量，他们还可以扩展自己。
Just like Krishna appears in different places, so also these devotees can appear in different places.
就像 Krishna 可以展现在不同的地方，显现在不同的地方，这些奉献者也可以显现在不同的地方。
This was seen, for example, when Krishna married 16,100 queens after he'd rescued them from the prison of Bomasura. Krishna married 16,100 queens, so they performed the wedding ceremony for all the queens all at the same time, and Krishna sat in the ceremony for all the marriages andHis mother and father also came for all the marriages.
就像 Krishna 从这个恶魔从那里劫走了16,100个妻子，和他们结婚的时候 ，Krishna 同时和所有的这些妻子都有各自不同的这个仪式，就是结婚的庆典。同时 ，Krishna 的父母也同时显现在这。每一个人的婚礼之上。
Was that? 这有一个问题，从星期二三题。
对，是的。
我想有别的女的有一个问题，以前没有，只有一个，只有她。
对对，只有她一个人的问题，好像没有其他人的问题了。
好 ，OK。
然后今天我们又哈日邦萨帕布又问了一个问题，我转过来了。
哈里瓦姆萨说，之前听咕噜说，如果神像没有被好好的照顾 ，Krishna 可能会离开神像。我很担心，怎样的标准和心态能确保主一直居住在神像里面？I heard from the Gurudev, when we not take care of the deities, the Krishna will go away from the deities. So I'm worried. What's the standards and the mood can make sure the Lord can stay in the deities always?
Well, two qualities are very important. One thing is cleanliness, and the other thing is punctuality.
两个标准是非常重要的，第一个是清洁，第二个是准时。
You're going to worship the deity, you should be clean. You have to bathe before you go and worship the deity.
如果你要崇拜神像的话，你必须清洁，你得在崇拜神像之前沐浴。
Ideally, you should put on dhoti and you should put on tilak.
理想的话，你应该穿上兜体，涂上提拉克。
Wear the dress of the devotee.
这是奉献者的打扮。
And if it's a woman, if she's contaminated, she cannot worship the deity, and she's not supposed to cook either.
如果是一个女士的话。当他处于例假的时候，他是被污染的，他也不应该给神像做饭。
So you may say, "Oh, how will I eat?"
你可能会想，那我吃什么
？So you have to cook those at that time when your wife's.We refer to the women when they're in that condition. We say the woman's off the altar today. She, in other words, she's in that period, the monthly cycle. So she cannot go on the altar, she cannot worship the deity, she cannot cook.
所以在女性的那个例假期间，女性不应该进神像房，也不应该在神坛，进神坛，她也不应该给神像做饭，你应该自己做。
So this is the standard of devotion, that you want to be pure and clean and be punctual, means regularly you do the worship on time.
这是你想崇拜神像，这是崇拜神像的这个标准。你想你应该变得纯洁。干净而且准时。
嗯。好嘞。还有吗？
没有。
没有。OK， 今天。今天到这儿。我们感谢苏古里来普布给我们整台的翻译，感谢萨提玛的记住者，我们感谢所有的奉献者。聆听 T1， 祝福你们，好好念诵，唱诵，变快乐，万事如意 ，Hare Krishna， 释迦牟尼佛 ，Ki， Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Ki， Hare Bol。